Hi everyone, Mrs. Chung here. Hope everyone is well and staying safe. Today I wanted to share with you a piece of choreography, just some dance moves, nothing too hard. This is something that everyone can do from kindergarten all the way through to year six. If you are doing your learning at home, get parents involved, get siblings involved as well. And of course, if you're doing your learning at school, get the teachers up as well. So this piece is to a song called Rock Your Body by the Black Eyed Peas. They have many, many hits and really cool film clip that goes with this song. You might like to check it out later. But also it has a very, very obvious beat, which makes it super easy to dance to. Now, some of you might be familiar with this choreography. If you auditioned for Southern Stars, you would have had to do this for your audition. And also, if you were here in the last week of term two, you may have also done this with Miss Donaldson and myself in the Art Hub. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to warm up. So find some space and make sure you're wearing something comfortable. All right, so now we're ready for our warm up. Plenty of room, comfortable stretchy clothing, comfortable shoes. If you're at school and you're in your uniform, that'll be perfect. So this is Boom Boom Pow. So we're gonna warm up our joints. Ear to shoulder.
Gotta get dead.
Oh, that feels good.
Gotta get dead. Gotta get dead. Gotta get dead.
Side. legs. Now we're ready to dance. So I'm going to explain the moves first before we try it to the music. Of course, when the music starts, it will be a little bit faster, so just try to keep up. So the first movement is just simply marching. Opposite arm to opposite leg, a straight back, chin up, and a serious face. Of course, we don't march like this. Okay, it just doesn't look convincing. Straight after that, we will be crouching down, bending our knees, thumbs in imaginary pockets. We are going to move our shoulder to the opposite side. So we go over, over, and then we do a double. Over, over, double. So a single, and a double. We will do that 4 times. After we do that, we turn our body and we snake. We snake our body, so it's our shoulders going back and sitting on an imaginary chair. Back, turn your body, do it 2 times to the other side. Snake, snake. After that, we do the rainbow, which is arms all the way up and down. When you do that, look up at your hands. So it's over and down. Then I want you to freeze, and then we melt down to the floor. Now, just remember that when we do that, we will be freezing and then we will be melting. And when you melt, try to make it look like you're melting. So all the way down to the floor. So marching, head up. So get ready for the shoulder, shoulder, double. Ready?
I wanna rock right now.
Where it gets really fun. You get to put your own creative spin on the dance, and I want this to be unique and personal to you. You will be coming up with some poses. Now, I suggest moving to a mirror if you are at home and just finding a movement that you can stop and freeze in. Don't forget to use your face as well. Your face should be matching your move. Now, your move can be big and wide. It can be small and low. It can be stationary on the ground, sideways. It even can be to the back of the room. So basically what I was doing in the Art Hub was clapping and saying, pose, pose, pose. And every single time I did that, the students had to think of a new pose. So if you are in the classroom, maybe you can have your teacher stop the video here and try doing that. You're going to need about 6 poses all up. You shouldn't have them rehearsed. You shouldn't try to remember 6 poses in a row. It should just be natural and flowy, okay? Now you will hear exactly when it needs to come in, and we will do it with the music, and I can show you my poses and then you can add your own poses. Poses and our other 3 poses, we are going to have some movements in between. So after your first 3 poses, you are going to bend and you're going to brush your shoulders off. And it's about that same timing. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you'll have your other 3 poses, and your next movement will be bending your knees, fingers on the temples of your head, roll, 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 roll. Okay, so it is pose, 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 brush, 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 pose, 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 head, 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 head. So marching. Get ready for your single, single, double. So this next part is the quickest transition. So straight after this part, we're going into this move immediately. It is a jump and a whip. A jump and a whip. Notice I am jumping that way, but I'm using this arm. So it goes up when we jump, and then it's whip. Jump, whip. Bend those knees. Two times that way. Jump, whip. Jump, whip, and one more time. Jump, whip, jump, whip. Then we stop, legs are apart, our hand is on our hip, and we put our fingers together. This is not a gun. This is how hip hoppers like to give props when they like a performance. But we're going to go like this. Rock your body. So it's straight into the jump, whip, jump, whip, jump, whip, jump, whip, jump, whip, jump, whip, rock your body. Straight after that, we get our hands, our fingers, we stick them under our armpits, we turn to the side casually, and we rock. Both our knees bend when we rock. We go one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. Now to turn, you are going to pivot on your toes. So it's one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. And then we are going to do some robot dancing. Okay, robot dancing. One, two, three, four. Arms are straight like a robot. We go down. We turn at the waist. We turn back. We come up. So try it with me. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Row, bot, dan, sing. Now this next move, for me, it's the most fun move. You can show a little bit of your personality when doing this. It's simply walking while you're sort of banging your knees, but I'm not banging them hard. I'm just doing like a funny walk. While I do that, I'm going to roll my hands forward, just like this. Now, when we hear this part of the music, I really want to have fun with this move. So you're allowed to move around with it. I don't want to just see you staying in one spot. I want to see you moving around, having fun. Maybe you want to get low. Maybe you want to go to one side. Maybe you want to go to the other side. It's up to you to just vary it. But at the very end of doing that move, you are going to become a DJ. And you are going to go one, two, when you hear my cue. Okay, so let's put it all together from the very beginning. Try to come in on that beat.
Shaking it from the bottom and top. Freak to what the DJ drop. We be the ones to make it hot.
To make it hot.
Electric shot.
A couple of hints about dancing. So I understand that dance isn't something that's for everyone. It doesn't feel natural to a lot of you. Some of you feel really embarrassed or uncomfortable. Mrs. Chung, well, a song comes on and I just can't help but move along with the beat. Now, that doesn't mean that we can't all have a go. It doesn't mean that we can't be successful dancers, but it does take a little bit of acting. So dance does actually fall into a little bit of drama. To be a good dancer, you need to use your face. It's that simple. You are so much more interesting to watch when you use your face and when your expressions match your moves. The other thing is too that if you don't have a really good go and you look uncomfortable or miserable up on a stage or wherever you're performing, the attention is automatically going to shift to you and people will watch you because it will take away attention from everyone else that's doing the move correctly or the people that are putting a lot of effort in. So just remember, you won't look silly trying hard and having fun, but you will stand out if you are standing still and looking so embarrassed. So just act confident, act chilled, and act like you're having fun. We all know how to put a pretend smile on our face. It's just that simple. The other thing is practice. Okay, I don't just shine the first time I do a dance. I have to practice and practice and practice. I like to practice it in front of the mirror so I can see myself and so I can give myself that critical feedback that's really important. Now, when we talk about memory and remembering dance steps, body memory is very real. The more you do something over and over again by moving your body, the more your body will automatically go from one move and shift into the next one. So that transition becomes automatic. So please practice and practice this as many times as it takes for you to just do it automatically. Okay, have fun, everyone.